Hello friends, this is Dr. Shonali here, and today we are discussing Grand Test CLT with the OBG Gynecologists and AIIMS as well. So question number 167, the correct answer is option B. Now, arrest of descent is no descent of head or no rotation for the time period is important for 3 hours in primary and 2 hours in multi, right? The glute indication of cesarean section in breech. And then the other thing to remember is sometimes they ask like breech with preeclampsia or any other example, breech with preeclampsia or any other complicating factor, right? In all these cases also cesarean section, right? But these are the relative indications, but choose a cesarean section in the answer. Very important, all aspects of cervical cancer are important beginning from screening. I have emphasized it a lot of number of times that oncology is very important. So from screening to staging to treatment to post-op treatment is very important. So today I will give you some important points about the pap smear. What the pap smear report can show, right? So pap smear report can show infections, right? It can show gardenella, it can show candida, it can also show trichomonas, but what it will not show is chlamydia. What it will not show is chlamydia. But what I want you to remember here, this is, has been asked in the PGI and the recent guidelines have also changed. What you have to do if there is ascus, right? If there is ascus, there is no direct colposcopy anymore. There is no direct colposcopy anymore. You have to either do, the preferred action is basically a high risk HPV testing. This is also called as HPV triage. This one has to do, or one can just repeat after 1 year. Repeat PAPs after 1 year if this is not possible, but this is the preferred action, is HPV testing, and if it is positive then go for colposcopy. Regarding proliferative and secretory endometrium, they can give you the slides also, they can give you the ultrasound pictures also to identify which kind of an epithelium it is, which kind of an endometrium it is, and also they can give you direct questions. So we will see important points about proliferative endometrium. And important points about the secretory endometrium. So important points to remember about the proliferative endometrium is that there are narrow and tubular glands, which is also known as called as telescoping of glands. Right, there is no leukocytic infiltration and the stroma is less cellular. All right, it is loose syncytial stroma. On the other hand, in secretory endometrium, the first change that comes is on day 7, and during the time of implantation, the endometrial thickness is 10 to 14 mm. So there should be no confusion regarding the thickness of the endometriums in various phases of the menstrual cycle. And reserve is antral follicular count. Day 3, antral follicular count. And the Gartner's duct. Gartner's duct. They are on the lateral aspect of broad ligament. It could be Kallman syndrome. One thing, in Kallman syndrome, what will happen? The FS and LFSH is going to be decreased. The other thing, it can be gonadal dysgenesis like Swyer syndrome. Okay, Swyer syndrome it could be, and then in that case the LH and FSH is going to be increased. Okay, now if there is no information about LH and FSH and Kallman syndrome is given, then you also you choose the Kallman syndrome as an answer, because this is more common than gonadal dysgenesis. Okay, Kallman. So the first one is a succinturate lobe, right? A succinturate lobe in which there is an additional lobe. There is this lobe and there is this lobe. There is a leash of vessels connecting, right? So this most common complication with this would be a PPH because of retained tissue. Because of retained tissue, right? Most common complication would be a PPH because of retained tissue. Then if these two lobes are equal with a leash of vessels, this is called bilobata, right? Then the other thing is that if there is a big K, so it can undergo thrombosis and compression. Okay, remember these points. So by this we complete the discussion of this test. You have to focus on the figure based questions in gyne, which are gyne obs, which are important, and also on the clinically based questions as far as the AIIMS exams are concerned.